look better than I did last time you saw me, Pavel.
At 63,
I'm good. How are you?
Even Frank Briggs knows he's lucky to be alive.
Days are good, days are bad. Today's a good day.
Briggs remembers suffering tremendous chest pain at his home in Hiram.
Could hardly stand up, couldn't sit up too well. I mean, just you wanted to get away from it, and you can't get away from it. And the wife called the rescue squad.
During the ambulance ride to UH Geauga Medical Center, a blocked artery in his heart triggered his first full cardiac arrest, and the first of many times he would be shocked to restore a normal heart rhythm.
Stand clear.
I was wide awake, and they said, we got a shock, and did the thing. I heard the machine winding up, and then pow.
If he would have been at home, you know, he would not likely have been able to have been rescued.
And then as he came into the emergency room, continued to have multiple cardiac arrests after cardiac arrest, I think for 26 or 27 events.
For the following 45 minutes, the hospital staff performed continuous CPR, administered drugs and repeated defibrillations, trying to keep him alive.
You know, they would shock him. The amount of time that his heart was beating on its own became shorter and shorter because that artery was occluded.
He continued to go in and out of shockable rhythm while he was in there.
But the fact that, you know, he was sort of moving in between these shocks and, you know, he very much was fighting to stay alive.
After having been shocked an amazing 34 times, a stent was successfully placed in the blocked artery, and days later, Briggs was able to go home.
This is the first time I can remember more than 30 shocks and a person going home in the shape that Mr. Briggs is in.
I don't know how I'll never be able to repay. They all did their job. And it was a successful happening. I don't want to do it again.